All right, y'all. So this episode of Chasing Dallas was giving what it was giving. So let's give it what we got.
What does the cat do?
So the episode starts off with us seeing King Kane do what King Kane does. If he ain't reading, baby, he is styling, styling down. He was down to the fashion show, styling these women down. They was looking beautiful. They was looking gorgeous. They was looking regal. They was looking beat, honey. And he was pinning and poking it. You did that. And I love to see y'all in y'all's element. I love to see y'all shining. I love to see y'all doing what it is that y'all were put on this earth to do. I feel like even when you're not doing something religious or spiritual, if you are walking in the calling that God has set for you, when I see you doing that in your element, I see God. And I saw that. I saw you just being yourself, just moving like it was second nature, like a machine. And I really want to shout you out because the fact that you're not ashamed to say, bitch, I don't work on weekends. I got a job. And since I had some free time, let me do my hustle. Like, I'm very open about that too. Talking about the fact that I work a full-time job. Like, I'm a regular person. Hell, Marla Gibbs was on, I don't know, what show was it? Was it 227? Whatever show she started off with, she was still working at the airport. Because she didn't have no security in there. She was just like, y'all ain't paying me what I need to be paid. Okay. The lady from the Tyler Perry play. She was still working while she was on tour with the goddamn play. Do what you gotta do to make what you need to make. Okay. Dior and his best friend. Now, this scene was really touching. He was first talking about his hair product line. He was like, I need to get the labels. I need to do this. I want to do my edge control, but I don't want it to be caked up, this, that, and the third. Then they moved on talking about his father. And he was just like, I don't have a relationship with my dad. I don't. And I want to know why. Like, is it because I'm gay? Is it because he's embarrassed? Like, what is it? Like, I didn't see him down to the family reunion. And everybody was like, oh, this, oh, that. You're so popular. You're so this, you're so that. I love you. And when the shine is on me and I'm the star of the room, then I'm your son. Then I'm your boy. But bitch, when I need you, I don't hear from you. Like, he got other kids and I see them all the time on social media reaching out and showing their daddy love, taking pictures, going out on events. And I don't have that. And I want to know why. Why are you doing me so differently? And to make matters worse, y'all, he said one night he was down to the wherever he was at, just partying, partying, partying. And something happened, the phone died, he needed a ride home. So he went down to the Quick Stop, was using the payphone, and while he was calling his ride on the phone with his ride, his daddy pulled up. So he like, y'all, no shade, but fuck y'all. My daddy here. I don't need a ride. I'm good. He hung up on the people, walks up to his dad and is like, hey, daddy, can I get a ride? The daddy look at him like he got shit on his face. The dude are like, okay, let me take a beat and like try to talk to him once he come out. So he comes out and Dior is like, dad, it's me, your son. Ain't you going to the north side? I need a ride. He was like, yeah, but
I ain't got no room.
Then the man was in a pickup truck, but he was in a pickup truck, so he had a whole flatbed. Dior was like, I could have sat in a trunk. I could have sat in the bed of the truck. Like, you literally, like, got in your truck and left your son. You left me. Like, what the fuck? And that, I don't even know what that feels like. I've never left anybody, and I've never been left ever in my life, and I pray that never happens. Yikes. I can relate to you a little bit on the non-connection with the father. Not gonna get into it. But, and the reason why I'm not going to get into it is because I have faith that it's going to get better. And I don't want to tarnish this man or our relationship. And I want it to get better. You know, I recognize that it is shitty, but I do want it to get better. So here's hoping that you, Dior, find the peace that you need to either reconcile whatever you have going on with your father or settle with the fact that you're never going to have a relationship with him and you be the dad to your kids that you wanted him to be to you. And shout out to your mama for being both a mother and a father, because she did that. You turned out to be a substantial, remarkable, successful man. Be proud of that. I'm only going to talk about this scene because it was literally just four scenes in this short-ass episode. So Reese is going to put out a book, and he was meeting with a photographer to talk about, like, cover ideas and how he wanted the shit to look and the photography and the promo behind it all. He was like, thank Oprah, because I'm the next great Oprah. Yes, ma'am. Baby, you might be Oprah in that scene, but bitch, you was giving me Donna Summers down to the confessional. Yes, yes, Reese. Now, giving you the real tea, did not like it because I guess he felt like it was a little mangy and a little unkempt, but I love the big hair on you and the fact that you was just like, ugh. Like, it just looked good. Like, you've been doing these confessional looks. I did not like the Dorley cutout, but everything else you've been giving, Reese. Shout out to you and these confessional looks. You and King Kane. This bustier King Kane got on is everything. Dior, I gotta give you your shine too, boo. Cause you giving. Howard, you was giving. Trey, when you had that crew neck sweatsuit on, you was giving. Like, y'all are giving in these confessionals, and I am here for it all. Y'all look so beautiful. Then the final scene, we have King Kane, Trey, and eventually Rock. So King Kane and Trey are sitting down or whatever. They talking about the lingerie party. And Kane was like, I'm not inviting Curious George because I don't think that he even like it because he's so spiritual. And plus, we just don't get along, and I don't want his energy in my goddamn party. So poof, pow, you're not invited. You don't get the camera time, bitch. Boom, 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 boom. But I'm kind of weird cute, like even though he said he a top and I know he giving all of us, I still want to see that body, honey. I want to see that body, Artie, because it looked like he got some under them clothes ever. And let me throw Rock and Knuckles show. So then Rock shows up and he like, y'all ain't thinking about me, so let me go get a drink since y'all up here drinking. First of all, bitch, you started the conversation off with sorry I'm late. So if we would have got you a drink, they only got frozen margaritas down to the Taco Cabana. So that shit would have been juiced by the time you would have got there. So do you really want us to buy you a drink? Girl, poof. They ain't but a dollar something and it looked like y'all was in between the happy hour limit. You know, so if y'all was between 4 and 7, that drink was what, half off? $1.50, girl, poof. So Kane get to talking about who he gonna invite and who he not gonna invite. He went down the list. Georgina not invited, blah, 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 blah. But everybody else is, like Dior. And then Trey was like, Dior? And King Kane was like, why the look? Like, girl, she's got the look. Like, why? And he was like, mm-mm. I don't know. We got history. We got, and he ain't going to it. But whenever a gay man say they got history, I believe some fucking is involved. Because I have conversated with quite a few dudes, but I'm not gonna sit up there and say we got history. There's a dude who I never slept with, never kissed, but we kind of flirt with each other whenever we're around each other. I'm never going to say me and him have history. Because we don't. If you got history with somebody, you got history with somebody. And if y'all used to date, then you would have said that. You fucked him. But anyway, Trey was like, mm-mm, we used to talk or whatever. And I'm trying to figure out why y'all fell out. Because you jumped from we used to talk to him and his son talking shit about me online. I'm missing a gray area. What caused y'all to fall out? What caused the friction? Because usually when somebody stops talking to somebody, it just kind of fizzles out, fades away, dies out. Y'all just kind of see less and less of each other until y'all just running into each other at events. That's typically how the shit goes. But if y'all have legit beef or legitimately not talking, then baby, it's something in them... Something in the milk ain't clean. So what is going on? And then for the son to feel like he should throw out some comments. Y'all down to the Facebook and how we calling you stuffed. That was not a laugh. I choked on something. But he calling you stuffed. He calling you stuffed. And that's not cool. Like, I'm trying to figure out why is his son feeling like he got jurisdiction to say that. First of all, even if y'all not cool, if I am the child, the friend, the cousin of somebody who is in a beef with somebody else, I'm not the type of person that's just gonna go on social media and dog you. Because first of all, that's not my beef.
Unless your ass get disrespectful. So don't call it. Love ya.
I ain't got nothing to say to you. That's y'all's situation. Now, I'm not finna be kiki and laying up with you and just having teas and cocktails, but I ain't got nothing against you either. Yet, Howard felt the need to call you stuffed on social media. And you say that Dior, Beth Dior was like, and so I'm just like, and this is my first time hearing about this shit. We're on episode what? And this is my first time hearing that y'all got some whatever going on. Where the fuck is Wuda? And Aubrey and Premier? Like, come on. Come on. Where the people? Where is the people? But y'all, honestly, that was really the whole episode. The episode was 30 minutes. 30 minutes, y'all. I'm trying to squeeze blood out of a tunnel. But I can't. So this was given when it was given. Love you, Imani Van Zandt. I really hope that you do the reunion because you are giving what you are giving. Shouts out to Yes Bitch TV giving you the real tea. Everybody else who is involved in reviewing this show, we've built like a little hub and we all kind of support each other. Love y'all. Love the support that we are giving to other Black gay creatives. It's amazing. But yeah, this episode was given what it was given, so I gave it what I had. Make sure you are liking, commenting, subscribing, and that your notifications are on. Same place, same time.